Story. Alien in Wonderland. I was in deep sleep. I do not know what this jet lag means. Therefore day, night, time difference, all these had no meaning. When I woke up, the plane was still flying high up in the sky. Most of the people were deep asleep. Having stepped into aircraft for the first time, I enjoyed traveling from Mumbai to Mauritius and then to Madagascar. The food in the aircraft had little appeal to me. I found people drinking colorful liquid one glass after another and asking for more. My father told me to keep quiet and enjoy apple juice. I was a bit scared to have that too, because if I drink more I may have to disturb my father to take me to the toilet again and again. My mother was fast asleep, as she was tired, rather too tired. As for the past 3 months she was working, overworking to pack and find our home in Nangal village in Punjab, North India. I was trying to forget my friends Somesh, Atul, Pinky, Gurmeet, the Sikh boy with turban, all around 6 to 8 years age. How can I forget them? They were my buddies, always ready to roll out their cycles to go on cycle safari all around our colony. We were feared by most of the elders, as they were too scared to take out their cars when we were cycling. They would ask their aunties or old girlfriends to stand out and stop us if they were parking or reverse their cars. From early morning school bus journey to evening home return and then evening cycle safaris after mandatory tuition sessions, we all had great fun. Most of the times, I had my snacks and evening dinner with my neighbors, either in Somesh's house or Pinky's place. I hate eating alone at home, that too in the company of Dadu, grandfather, as he would start advising how to eat and how not to waste food. In my friend's place it was fun, as the TV would be on, we could eat whatever placed on the plate with Pokemon, Doorman and Spider-Man's company. Dadu, I miss you and I am sorry today I junked the sandwich in the plane, as I found the same stale. We all spoke Punjabi, Hindi and little English. The day spent in Mumbai was fun. Jha Beach was for the first time I saw a sea. Arabian Sea, big, massive, eternal roar of waves kept me mesmerized. I could touch the seawater, taste the seawater. Very salty. I had good pav bhaji of Mumbai. That was yummy. Then we went to airport early morning. From then on I felt like I have been blindfolded and left all along. A few spoke Hindi. None spoke Punjabi. I could hardly understand languages like English, French, Malagasy, etc. The air hostesses were kind. I could two gift bags which were meant to children busy in the air. But I could hardly read anything, therefore played with a model plane which kept me busy for some time. On landing in Madagascar, I was taken to our home which was very nice. But there were hardly any Somesh, Atul, Pinky, Gurmeet to play with. There is a factory, a few Indian uncles fortunately speaking Hindi. Apart from that there are servants who speak a funny language called Malagasy. I tried to make a marking on the road with bricks to play hip-hop. The servants were happy to join me to play the same. But stopped on seeing the bald boss of my father, general manager, calling Patron, "Boss, is coming." I was sleeping in the afternoon. From our window, I could hear the sound of children playing. They may be Malagasy children, but their playing sound has no language. It is like the chirping of birds, which has no language, universal language. I have made up my mind, when my father comes I am going to tell him to drop me near the playground every day morning. I am not go back to India too soon. But I will get local Somesh, Atul, Pinky, Gurmeet, they may be called David, Andre, Anja, Diana and Ionja. I do not mind. My circle will build up and I shall be happy, rather than staying all alone. Brooding over my plight.